Thank you, everybody. Welcome to the Southern. Welcome to R4 and DeForzo. That's how you pronounce it, in case anyone was wondering. We're so happy to be here. That song you just heard was a song by Thundercat called Tron Song, just get everybody warmed up. And we're going to continue now with some of my compositions and some of these songs that Andrew has arranged for this incredible band. We're going to introduce the band to you as the night goes on. Let's hear it first, though, for Andrew Randazzo on the bass. Yes, he approached me months ago about doing this and said, hey, I want to arrange your music for a big band. So I thought about it for 1 second. Yes, please. So the song we're going to start with is called Dutch. I wrote this my first year at the New School in New York when I was 21. And it's so cool to be playing this now here that I'm 25. And nobody believed it. This is called Dutch, and we first recorded this song, a trio with Andrew and Devon at Devon's studio. And if you listen to that version, you'll hear a lot of the stuff that's in that version has been incorporated into this arrangement. So this is called Dutch.
Oh,
Thank you, everybody. Whoa, this feels really good. I'm loving my life right now. This next tune is called Bedroom. It's one that I wrote for, as in the bedroom. It's a song that I wrote for a movie called Flytrap, if you want to check it out, by Miles Kahn. It's a 12-minute short film. And this is written for Vimeo. Yeah, on Vimeo, not YouTube for some reason. I don't know. Vimeo. Anyway, this is written specifically for to be music behind a conversation that's been had by two people in bed. So it's a beautiful composition. Andy, would you like to say anything on that?
I'm going to go out on a limb here and say this is going to be a track off of Charles' string quartet album, which will come one day. That's out of the bag.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Benroot, as in the. This next one is a song that I did not write, but I recorded this song on an album called As One that was released. Yes, some As One fans. One As One fan. with Andrew on electric bass, Devon on keyboards, and Kelly Strawbridge on drums. And this song is called Steppin' Out. I happen to be the generation that I grew up listening to Steppin' Out on the radio. And Andrew is in the generation of growing up listening to Steppin' Out on video games. So we both love it though. From PS2 to FM radio. Anyway, this is a great arrangement of Steppin' Out. There's a bit of another song incorporated into it. Andy and I were driving up to New York to play at Smalls, and we wanted to play Steppin' Out, but we didn't want to play it in the normal way. And so the bass line of this song shares notes with another song called 4 on 6 by Wes Montgomery. And so we thought that we would incorporate some of that into this arrangement. So this is Andrew's arrangement of Steppin' Out. We hope you like it. I do.
Thank you.
J.C. Cool on the baritone saxophone and the flute. We got Susie Fisher on the alto sax and flute. Susie Fisher. Kevin Simpson on the tenor sax and flute. I'm going to keep introducing the band as the night goes on. This next one we're going to do is one that I wrote. It's one of another earlier tunes. It's called Love Saves the Day. I used to live in the East Village in New York City, and there was a little store on 2nd Avenue that I used to pass every day. It was called Love Saves the Day. And it also stands for, the first letters of all those words also stand for something else, which I was unbeknownst to me at the time. So that's not, this is about love saving the day, because it does save the day. And Andrew has a couple things to say about this, I'm sure.
This is definitely one of the first tunes of Charles that I ever played, probably like 2012, I think. And we recorded it for an album called A Wealth in Common, which is cool. It's just, it's another trio album, tenor sax, upright bass, and drums. And yeah, man, I mean, Charles has had a big influence on me and just my musicianship. I mean, from playing with someone for so long, you can't really avoid that sort of thing. But, you know, yeah, I tried really hard. And it just seeped right in. But this is, you know, this is definitely one of the ones where I, you know, it spoke to me on, like, you know, it's not your standard sort of thing, but it's just really rooted in accessible harmony, I guess. And yeah, this is when I was like, yeah, me and Charles are kind of coming from the same place in a lot of ways musically, so had to do this one. Can we give it up for Love one time? Come on, for Love one time. Anyway, here's Love Saves the Day.
Thank you.
Dimitriadis on the trombone. Stefan Dimitriadis. Pete Anderson on the trombone. Pete Anderson. Ben Whisker on trombone. Ben Whisker.
Give it up one time for George Gershwin. Big inspiration for doing this. So, Gil Evans is a huge influence of mine. Definitely one of the reasons why I wanted to do a gig like this, which you can see we got a couple of empty chairs back here, the keyboard and the guitar player coming on second set. But I wanted to just do saxophone, bass, drums, and horns. And that comes from Gil. I got that from Gil, and one of my favorite Gil and Miles recordings is Porgy and Bess. And if they do this one, my version's a little different. I try to take a little more from the actual, like, original Gershwin opera version. But then there's also sort of like the standard version that everyone plays, so there's a little bit of that too. And anyway, this one's called It Ain't Necessarily So.
Thank you.
George Gershwin, arranged by Andrew Randazzo. Keep it going for Will Evans on the trumpet, Will Evans. Marcus Tenney on trumpet, Marcus Tenney. Mambo Bob Miller on the trumpet. Sam Koff on the trumpet. DJ Harrison, Devon Harris on the drums. Can't believe the set is almost over. But we have a whole other set for you tonight. And Andrew has written some amazing stuff. Marcus is gonna do some rapping. We're gonna have Adam Larrabee out here on the guitar. We're gonna have, yes. This last one is a song that I wrote. VJ is here, I think, and loves it when I tell this story. I wrote this song, it's called Losing Victory, and my wife and I, when we first got together, she broke up with me. Perhaps you didn't hear that. You guys were like, yeah, I can see that. Sounds good. Anyway, story over. Screw you guys. And I wanted to write this piece because I was feeling sad and I was longing for her. And luckily we got back together. Love you, Veach. But this song is called Losing Victory, and VJ's name is means victory. And so, Andrew, you want to have anything to say about that?
Yeah. Also, there's a version of this out there floating around from Ez One, Charles Ez One. On Spotify, iTunes, anywhere you listen to music, you can find it. It's me on this bass. Devon actually plays keys on that album. Charles plays sax. We have Kelly Strawbridge on drums. Just want to say real quick, huge thank you to the Charlottesville Jazz Society for co-sponsoring this event. Yes. If you want to keep up with everything they're doing, there's an email list out in the lobby, so go just sign up. I know you guys have tons of junk mail in your box. It's easy to unsubscribe from just one of those and then put your name on this list. Come on. Yeah. Yeah. 2019.
Thank you.
on. Let's give it up for Charles one time, real big.